We go on with the articles. We talk about pain fracture treatment algorithm.
Professor Chang, ladies and gentlemen, Hansin, thank you for the invitation to this report. I'm very happy to be here. In the first presentation of me, I want to speak about the injuries of the upper cervical spine. The common injuries are car traffic accidents, young people, free time activity, young people too, and casual fall or people. It's a big patient quality. To the epidemiology, we have about 2% on all spinal injuries in the cervical spinal region, and about 30% of the cervical spine injuries are localized in the upper cervical spine, C1, C2. For all axis injuries, 50% of the odontoid proximus fracture. It's a typical for West countries, fracture of the old man, 70 years and older. The common classification which we use is an endosondylosis, so type 1, 2, and 3, and many operators modify the type 2 endosondylosis classification as the isoerosion, especially to use the exact approach for the operation. To endosondylosis classification, type 1 is only the apex of the odontoid process, the fracture rate, and its common stable fracture. Type 2 is a horizontal fracture or the fracture of the basis of the odontoid process. And type 3 is the fracture line through the odontoid process from the curves of the axis. The modification of this classification is type 2, endosondylosis, isoerosion. It's depends on the fracture line. If you have a horizontal line, fracture line, you can treat this fracture from ventrally with one or two screws. If you have the type B, this classification, the patient has a horizontal fracture line from cranial ventral to caudal dorsal, so you can treat this through the ventral excess. Type C is more problematic. The cranial dorsal and caudal ventral fracture line, it's not usual to treat this fracture ventrally, so you make the dorsal approach. In our patient study group, we have 10 years overview with 131 odontoid process fraction type 2 and 3, and we follow up by similar 100 patients. 30% are women and 60% men. It's the relationship between the injury cases and the age of patient. You can see on the left side of the PS a high peak. It's the car injuries, traffic injuries, the young people, motorcycle, and on the right side, the older patient, casual fall, still fall, and the same. If we look at the relationship between dense fracture to all spine injuries and patient age, we see that dental fracture is about 70 and older patients, the common fracture. We have studied the symptoms, the typical symptoms for this injury. We haven't found any. The neck pain or headache are no significant or no specific symptoms for injuries. There are many studies with normal population, the population after distortion of the cervical distortion. They have the same problems as our study group patients. But what is very important for our patients after our operative treatment? You want to achieve a surgery, union of the fracture and stability. And if we compare this study, our study group with others, you can see the ventral fusion with one or two screws is a good operative method to create this fracture. We achieved about 9% non-union and above 90% union of this fracture type. What about the algorithm of this treatment? By fracture type 1, we have stable situation, so we target these injuries conservatively. We put the cervical protection, we don't operate this fracture. Type 2 endosymbiosis also, if the fracture is undislocated and horizontal fracture line, no neurological complication, we put the cervical protection and we operate the patient in the first 38 hours. We can use the anterior approach or dorsal fusion with a fixator. If we have a patient with dislocated fracture about 2 and more millimeters in CT scan, slope fracture line or ventral dorsal shifting, with neurological complication, we put the hello fixator and operate this patient in the first day. We use the same method for same access. Dense fracture type 2, the endosomial also with luxation, neurological complication, we put the hello fixator and operate this patient immediately or in the first 24 hours. Dense fracture type 3, no dislodge, no neurological complication, we protect in cervical orthosis, 6 to 8 weeks. The dislocated fracture, slope fracture line or ventral dorsal shift, no neurological complication, we put a hello fixator or, depend of the situation, comorbidities, operative treatment. I want to show you one case. Very difficult case, which show that the conservative treatment is not usually the best way, and we switch from time to time from one treatment way to the other. It's an 87 years old male with multiple co-disease, death and dumb, followed with a head injury at home. I had a dense fracture on type 2, as on the CT scan you can see. We make a close reduction because of odor and comorbidities, and done the close reduction with a fixator, with hello fixation, 5 days hospitalization. 2 weeks later, the patient is becoming ambulatory with pins dislocation. So we missed the first refixation, CT scan control. On the 25th of December, the patient will be admitted ambulatory by dislocation of the frontal pin. In the next step, we saw the patient ambulatory admitted because of skull pain, and we must do a pin transfer frontal right. After this time, the patient was admitted the next one with loosening of the pin, so make pin transfer. And more admitting ambulatory at the end with electrified pin screw, so we make CT scan. And so the situation on the picture down, you see the pins press the lamina externa and interna of the screw. The fracture is non-union of the right side, and we decide to refixation another place on the hello fixator. A few days later, the patient is repeating electrified pain and admitted to our department to make a CT scan for the sixth time, removing the hello fixator and protection cervical orthosis. Because of the pain and non-union, we saw the patient on the 5th of March and made the percutaneous dorsal myo fusion with good results. after two hospitalizations, 9 ambulatory consultations, 16 transfers, and 6 CT scans, controls, and intensive home care, recurrent pain. So we must change from non-operative to operative treatment from time to time. Thank you for that.